Hi everyone, how are you going this week? Today I thought I would start with some nice Easter ideas. So this is a little cup. It's not very easy to see on this angle. And I've got Happy Easter on the front. And it's just really, it holds so many eggs. Look how many, oh, heaps of little mini eggs. Or you can just fill it up with one big egg. So anyway, that was all the eggs I had, so I couldn't put any more in there. I will show you how to make this. It's really, really easy. And we're going to do it all together. All right, so what we need here is some bits and pieces. We need a piece of cardstock that measures, oh, hang on, I can't read that. 9.5 by 7.75. And another piece of cardstock that measures 2 inches by 6 inches, and we need 6 pieces of DSP that measure 1.25 inches by 3 inches, and another piece that measures 3/4 of an inch by 5 inches, a scrap of white for doing a little bit of stamping on, a 2-inch circle and a 2-inch scallop. So if you've got the dies or the punches, doesn't matter which. So there we go. So we'll pop them on one side and we're going to do our scoring together. Bring my scoreboard in. Okay, see if I can get it in the, oops, get it in the thing. And we're just going to score this one on the long side at the 1-inch mark. Okay. And this one we're going to score on the long side at 1.5 inches. I like to do 2 runs down. 3 inches. 4.5 inches. 6 inches. 7.5 inches. And 9 inches. Then we're going to turn it on the short side and we're going to score it at 1.5 inches and 5.25, I think that says. Hang on, let me have a look. 5.25 inches. And that's all the scoring we're going to do. Okay. So that's what we look like. So we're going to start by this small section here. I don't know if you can see it very well. On the, yeah, that bit there and this piece here we're going to remove. So we're going to cut down to this score line and just notch it. And we're going to notch this one and cut up there. So all we're left with is a piece in the middle here. Alright. Then we're going to do all our burnishing, fold and burnish all our score lines. On all our pieces. I think this is a really great project for your grandchildren or your young children or your workmates even. Okay, so that's all scoring on that, folding and burnishing on that one. And we're going to just do this one as well. Okay, so we'll do all the rest of our cutting, which is using the punch board. Now, I don't have a Stampin' Up board because I have a memory keepers board. And it's a 1-2-3 board, which is the same as an envelope punch board, but it does envelopes, bows and boxes. So we're going to now, on the short side here, we're going to, along this score line, we're going to match it up with the centre here as such, and we're just going to punch along there, and then we're going to fold it. This is going to get a little bit hard not too bad. Move the bits out. So if you've got a strong man in the house, ask him to punch for you, like I usually do. Just find, some days I have the strength, some days I don't. It's only that some card, like the Stampin' Up card, is such good quality that it's a bit thicker to punch through. Says me punching hard on it. And we're still going to do the very last one. Okay, so we've punched all them along the bottom. While we've got the punch board in, I can close them over. I'm going to just round the corners of my handle. Like so, and the piece of DSP for my handles as well. Well, I've got it here. Oh gosh, oh, it's already cut. Okay, so that's all our punching done. We can just put our board out of the way and we can start by assembling. So we'll start by assembling our handle, which is just a matter of gluing the two pieces together to give it some nice strength along there, and we'll glue our piece of DSP onto it as well, and then we'll pop that away because we don't need it again for a while. This is going to look funny because it's quite a bit shorter, but that's okay because this bit is going to be underneath, you won't see it. So we'll pop that on one side to dry a little bit while we do all the rest of our stuff for here. So on this piece now we're going to do a bit more cutting. We're going to cut up every one of these pieces at the fold line. Alright. And then we're going to put our DSP on while it's flat, because it's just easier to put on while it's flat. So we're going to just pop our pieces on. If you've got directional paper, just be careful you get all your directions the same way, unless you want to be abstract. This is actually a retired DSP, so it's a good way of using up some of the scraps. So I'm here to show you the technique, not the products as such today. Now just make sure that when you do these, you're closer to the top than you are to this bottom, because this will curve under so you won't see it. Like me, I put one upside down, one upside down. Never mind. He won't come off now, so he's stuck there. But believe it or not, he's behind the handle, so it won't matter. Okay, whoops. Pop him up the right way. Okay, so that's all our DSP on here. So just make sure they're nice and smooth and flat. And we're going to glue this down, but we're going to not glue right to the edge. We're going to glue about that far down. Just make sure when you are doing this that the longest part is at the top, the shorter bits at the bottom. Alright? And remember, we don't want to go Right. Did at the wrong end. Right at this end here. Okay. Then we're going to, oops. We're going to fold this around like so. And we're going to put a bit more glue on this tab here. And we're going to slide that in there so that it covers it nicely from the inside as well as the outside, and glue it together, holding it nice and tightly with sticky fingers. Never mind. All right. While that's gluing stuck there, we can start our inside. So what we're going to do for our base is we are going to take two ends opposite each other and pull that in just a tiny little bit. So we're going to put a bit of glue on here, and we're going to pull that right over so that this cut edge meets up where this, meets up with the line that's where it comes in. Alright, once we've done that, we'll put a little bit of glue on the underside of one and on the top of the same one, and we'll do the same again over the top. Hold it together as best you can. It's really quite an easy cut. Oh well. Project. And once again, a little bit of glue on the underside of one and on the top of the same one, and we're going to pull that over and pull that in and hold that for a few seconds. Once you've done that, you can just pop that in like that, and we have our cup shape. Now with our, we've got our 2-inch circle, we're going to pop that on the bottom. It just finishes that off so much nicer. Okay, so that sits on the bottom like so. Whoops. And he's ready to go. Alright, so then with our handle, what we're going to do is we're going to break the fibres. Okay. And we're also going to do the bottom bit the opposite way. Alright. And the top bit right over, because we're going to glue this section here with my cup stand there. We're going to glue that section to where the join is here. So whichever one, that's my upside down one. So that's where I'm going to stick him, on the upside down one. And we're going to glue him into place. And then once he's stuck, we'll give him a few seconds. I'll glue the other bit going the opposite way to the bottom to give us like a handle. Oops, a bit more glue maybe. Just going to do our little bit of stamping to put our little Easter thing on the side, so we'll pop him over there to dry for a moment. And I have here a piece of, just a scrap piece of white, and this handle doesn't want to stay. He's playing naughty people today. Okay. So, I have Highland Heather here and a very old stamp. It says, Happy Easter, because I'm not an Easter person that gives Easter cards, so this is a very old Easter card, Easter stamp, which I've stamped on here, and I'm using my 1 3/4 inch circle just to cut it out. Alright, and I'm going to glue him onto the back of this 2 inch scallop circle. And then I'm going to put a couple of dimensions, and I'm using my old ones again, but because I want them to be on the top and bottom because of where I'm going to put it. Alright, so pop them over there, and then we can put our Happy Easter on the front of our little mug, and there we go, that's it. I think he's so beautiful. And as I say, there's the other one, and it's quite heavy because there's about 200 grams worth of chocolate in there. So I would say one huge egg or a lot of little ones, depending on who you're giving them to. I'm sure you could size these down, but there you go. That's this week's project. I hope you like it. And I will be back with another Easter project, as we only have four more Saturdays before Easter Sunday. So, and I thought, well, if I don't eat all these beforehand, I will use them again next week to show you the next week's project. Okay, bye for now. Bye.